Morning, Michael.
Morning, Bumble. And what a morning it is, the Saturday of a Lord's Test.
Just ease through the offside. And Root moves to 50.
Another excellent innings from the England captain. Coming in under tremendous pressure on a hat-trick ball. He moved very fluently to his half-century. 82 balls, 7 fours, and looked very strong, square on the offside. Oh, he's been so strong, square of the wicket, back foot and front.
Nicely timed. Just skips over the fielder for four.
Yeah, made good ground, Siraj, and really should have stopped it, having made the ground. Lovely bit of timing from Bairstow. Siraj gets down early and really ought to have stopped it once he did.
Oh, it's going to go for four, and it's in the air. It's a false shot outside edge.
There's nowhere near carried, even so, and Best has pushed quite firmly at this, but it's landed a long way short of Rahane, and it's just done him for a bit of pace, really, because he's so close.
Bigger stride this time for Best.
For the game, actually, I just happened to be here filming something with Dinesh Kartik, saw Johnny coming out of the nets, and we just chatted for a while, and got the sense that he's pretty confident at the moment in his method, feels solid and secure.
Yes!
That's his best shot of the morning.
So far, so good, but I had the sense that he was by far England's second most solid looking player, you would say, after Root.
Yes. Oh, a nice half volley.
We saw Joe Root's wagon wheel a moment ago, and not one run has come in the, what you might call, the traditional V between mid-off and mid-on. I've seen him play two fours, two drives, one through mid-on and one through mid-off. So players playing in a very different way, different strengths, scoring in different areas.
Very delicate. All the way. Oh, fiddled away. Coley has got those slips apart, staggered. They're very close because the ball hasn't been carrying.
Yeah. Another half century for Johnny Bairstow.
It's his consistency. Definitely one of the better batters going around in England at the moment. Just the firm handshake says that to himself. He's happy with what he's doing.
Gone very fine. That could be four.
Batting. Remember a game, Andrew, and it'd be before your time, it was a test match at Headingley that I was playing in. And a wicket. Ooh, it's not far away from Rishabh Pant. Root almost got himself into a tangle down the leg side twice in the previous over. More solid technique in test cricket. And it's gone. This is good from India. Change of angle from Siraj, round the wicket, the short ball ploy has worked. Bairstow's ballooned one up off the glove and must go.
Well, India will be delighted, but England and Johnny Bairstow will be incredibly frustrated by this dismissal. He's fallen into the trap, it's the simplest of catches, and India are back in the game at the perfect opportunity.
Has to hurry and gets home. It's another 100 for Joe Root. Saturday of a Lord's Test match, one of the great days in the English cricketing calendar, and the England captain has graced it with another wonderful 100.
He was backing up a long way, but as soon as Root hit it, he was off. Not surprising, no one likes to be on 99 for very long. Just had a look at Butler, didn't he, to go, oh, it's going to be tight. But a brilliant innings from the England captain. He's in some of the form of his life right at the moment.
Edged and wide of second slip, just two slips in and a wide fifth slip. And this one beat Rohit Sharma to his right. It wasn't that far away.
Nicely timed. Not nicely done in the field, though. That's a little bit old school from Ishant Sharma. Probably aiming through the offside. It's ended up going through mid-on. And it's found the middle of the bat and it's ran all the way for four. Gorgeous shot. Off the back foot, through extra cover. And it's skated up the hill for a boundary. 266 for four.
There's some space on the offside. It's going up the hill. Full stretch dive to about. Butler picks up the boundary, even though Siraj put absolutely everything into it. Oh, thick edge, catchable, but through the vacant slip area. Yeah, that's the delivery, and once again Ishant Sharma gets Jos Butler.
And look at the pitch for Jos Butler. It was promising from him.
Seam position perfect, used the slope through the gate. Meanwhile, Joe Root just continues on his merry way of displaying wonderful shape and fantastic results.
That will go all the way. That brings up 300 for England as well, 300 for five. Good shot again, well timed. Down the slope, you won't catch that. And again. They took out the man that was reasonably fine. Leg slip. That's another boundary.
Was down in the tea break, actually, down pitch side. Very good from Moeen. The direct hit came, but Moeen Ali was a long way home. The direct hit allows Root to come back for a second. Given Moeen Ali some trouble with the direct hit, but he responded immediately.
It was close, but it was hit, well, it came off the edge too quick, and Joe Root goes to 150. Another masterful innings from England's captain.
He's got the smile, he's got the Midas touch in many ways.
Well, a special player, perhaps not quite where he intended it, but he'll take it, of course. Edged and taken, and Moeen says fine and walks off. It's a brilliant delivery. He's bowled some terrific deliveries in the last over or so. And Moeen Ali's resistance is over, though maybe he may hang around. I think the umpires are saying, let's check.
Copy. If we can just go through to the catch, please, now. Thank you. Okay, if you have anything from front on, please. Keep that going through, keep that going through. Thank you.
Well, here we got the dish in it.
Edged and taken, sharp catch, turn two for Ishan. India back in it.
Experience from Ishan Sharma just showing here.
Breakthrough that opened it up, and that is the perfect delivery. Has to play at it. Just moving away late from the left hand, and nothing you can do. You just have to walk off. That is too good. And that's a pretty simple catch, even though it went quickly, they are close.
What does the root do here on 90?
That's four. Give him a bit of room outside the off stump. Full toss. Put away as they should be. That's a bit straight up. Yes, give him. He may send it upstairs, Ollie Robinson, but that's a lot straighter than the previous ones.
TV umpire to director, we have a player review for LBW. Original decision is out. Okay, I'm just going to need to see Ultra Edge on this, please, when available. Thank you. We'll go back to Michael on field. Mistake the original decision. You're on camera now.
Don't think so. Still got one review left. He used two reviews up early in Root's innings. He's going to use his third.
We go back to Mike Onfields and stay with your original decision. You're on camera now.
It is a game of very fine margins. Great hands. And when he wants to, he can hit boundaries as well. That is his 15-4. Oh, he's gone. He's gone. Root came, then he sends him back. Mark Wood was not for turning. He's carried on trotting off to the pavilion. Jadeja, the fielder out there. And you can take some on, but he's a very difficult man to take on. Quick through, quick across the ground, and then a bullet arm, a flat throw into the stumps. But no fault of Mark Wood's here, because Root did want the second and then realised who was throwing the ball. Huge roar for Joe Root's 16th boundary. He moves to 170. England's lead is a dozen.
Oh, if you don't mind, the hundred's on. Not at Lord's, but Joe Root has just brought out a little bit of one-day cricket. He's got the slog sweep off Siraj. Trying desperately the dive in vain. Pleased to say that's a legal delivery. Last ball of the day, and Jimmy Anderson as bowled, which is the conclusion of the England innings. All out for 391. And the wicket will stand.
There couldn't have been a better finish for today. On a Saturday at Lord's,